I said at the beginning that we will need to create two forms, two graphical user interfaces. We have now finished the one for the main window, but we still need to create the form for opening the create new shapefile dialog. So if I click on this dialog in the actual tool on this button, I get the dialog box where I'm allowed to enter the name of the new shapefile and the field that should be added to it. So this we still need to create. So I'm going to use file new, and now I'm going to pick dialog with buttons bottom as the template to use, and then press create. So we now get a new form, which already has two buttons created. And we have to set it up that it looks like the dialog box we want. First of all, let's change the title. So under properties, we go to window title, and then we call this dialog create shapefile. And we save the whole form under the name GUI underscore new shapefile dot UI. Okay, now we have things set up. We can now start to add the missing widgets. And for that, I'm going to drop a grid layout at the top of this. And then I'm going to change the layout of the entire dialog box to a vertical layout. So as a result, we still have the buttons, the default buttons that were already created by Qt Designer at the top right. And we now have a grid layout above them so that we can add the other widgets to. I'm adding the two labels first. And I'm calling the first one new shapefile. And the second one field for name. And then I'm adding the two line edit widgets like that. And finally, a toolbar for the first row. And that's pretty much it. So we have now created the GUI for the dialog box. We're just going to save it. And now we're done. So we have created two forms, one called GUI underscore main and one GUI underscore new shapefile. And these can now be compiled into Python code and then used to create the complete tool to combine it with the code that actually implements all the functionality needed. And that's what you're going to see in the rest of this walkthrough.